Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss about some interview questions that you are seen on my notepad. So let's have discussed about these interviews questions. Like when you are preparing for interviews, then interviews ask some questions from you. So these are some questions, so we will discuss about these. The first question is, what is the difference between layer 2 and layer 3 switch? So as we have discussed in the course, switch is a device which is used to connect multiple another device with each other. Okay, so it has two types, layer 2 and layer 3. The first difference is layer 2 switch works on data link layer and layer 3 switch work on data link plus network layer. So we can understand easily. Layer 2 switch work as a switch function only, like they will learn only MAC address, but layer 3 switch work as a router also. So if they can work like a router also, they can work on different network ID, and layer 2 switch can works on same network ID. So layer 3 switch works as a router. Like for example, in your company you don't have any router, so you can transfer your traffic from one network to another network with the help of layer 3 switch also. Layer 3 switch also known as a multi-layer switch, and layer 2 switch is known as single layer switch. Rest, the functioning of switch remains same in both the switches, like first time broadcast and after that unicast. So these are the basic difference between layer 2 and layer 3 switch. Okay, next move on to another question. The question name is VTP. So what is VTP? Because we have discussed about VLAN and inter VLAN. So VTP is your layer 2 protocol, L2 protocol. So VTP protocol is used to transfer VLAN database from one switch to another switch. Like for example, in our company we have multiple switches and they are also connected with cross cable. So what we have to do, VTP is used where our switch to switch links are known as trunk ports. So VTP protocol is basically used with the help of trunk port transfer this switch VLAN database to another switch, and again this switch VLAN database to another switch. In VTP we have three modes of server, three modes of switches actually. First is server mode, second is client mode, and third is transparent mode. In server mode you can create VLAN, you can delete VLAN, you can change the name, and also you can send the updates of VTP, you can receive the updates VTP. So all the work is based on server. But in client mode of VTP, it is neither it is going to create VLAN nor delete VLAN. It is not able to send the VTP updates, but it only receive update from server switch. And on the other hand, transparent switch can send, can create the VLAN, can delete the VLAN, but neither it send the information nor it receive the information. So it is not used in the process of server and client. So on, in the rest we can say VTP is used to transfer VLAN database from one switch to another switch. Now let's move on to the important questions. Like 90% companies discussed about this question. The what is the need of subnetting? Okay, subnetting, first of all we need to know about what is subnetting. So subnetting is divide large network into small subnetworks. So as we know, if we are using A class, B class, C class, then we know they can work on FLSM, fixed length subnet mask. In A class we have 2 raised to power 24 host. In B class we have 2 raised to power 16 host. In C class we have 2 raised to power 8 host. So they have fixed host values, 256, 65, 536, 16 million. Now For example, you want to use 300 IP network. You need 300 IP in one network. So if you are using B class, then 236 IPs are going to waste. Okay, so if these IPs are wasted, then we are neither it used in WAN or in LAN. Why in LAN? Because we don't need in LAN. Why not we can use it in WAN? Because the network ID is same. If the network ID is same, then router does not allow to send packet from one network to another network with same network ID. So that's why we use subnetting. Instead of fixed length subnet mask, we can work on VLSM, variable length subnet mask. In subnetting, for example, I'm taking an example of C class. If in C class I'm using this network /24, then I have 256 IP. But if I need 300 IP, so this address is not used, I have to use for B class. Okay. In B class, 536 IP is used by /16. Okay. You have seen this video in our course. In 16, but if we change our 1 bit into 17, then IP should be half. If we again increase our bit value, then again IP should be half. I think it is 16384. If we change the bit again, it is equal to 8000 something. If we use the bit to /20, then 4000 something, 4k. /21, 2k, and /22, it is 1000 something, 1024. So in /23, when we change with the subnetting, IPs are 512. So if we have to use 300 IP, then our wastage is there, but it is less waste. Only 200 IPs are wasted instead of thousands of IP address. So with the help of subnetting, we can save our precious IP addresses. Okay, let's move on to the new question, IPv4 and IPv6. Like, what is the difference? First of all, IPv4 is a 32 bit address. IPv6 is a 128 bit address. In IPv4, we have 4 octet, like 8.8.8.8. But IPv6 is a great address, so it is divided by 16, 16, 16, like in hexadecimal part. Like 8 times 16, we have to use. In this, our network IDs like and host IDs based on classes. Like we have classes in IPv4, but in IPv6, we don't have any classes. In IPv4, we have 4.3 billion IP address. In IPv6, we have 3.4 undecillion IP address, like 10 raised to power 38 IP address, huge range of IP address. And after that, IPv6 routing is easier than IPv4. Okay. And besides this, we divide, for example, we have to work on FLSM. Then in FLSM, if we have 8.8.8.8, then we can divide it into 8, 16, 24, 32. And IPv6 is divided like 16, 32, 48, 64, 80, 96, 112, and 128. So IPv6 and IPv4 are used for the same purpose, like providing unique address, but they have so many different things. Okay, so move on to the last question, ACL. ACL stands for access control list. So access control list is the part of security. Like access control list is a set of commands which are grouped together for denying a packet, for receiving a packet, like for permitting the packet, or for filtering the packet. So like this is a range of commands and divided into two parts. Like you can provide ACL as a numbered ACL 1 to 199 and named ACL. You can use any word. Okay. So, now access list, control list is basically used for denying the IP. Like you want to prevent unauthorized access from outsider, so you have to use access control list. Further, these access lists are divided into two parts, standard ACL and extended ACL. Now the difference between standard and extended is this. Standard ACL used only source address for any condition test, but extended access list used for source as well as destination. If you want to block source to destination, then you can use extended ACL. Okay, and in standard ACL, number range is 1 to 99, and in extended 100 to 199. So basically, ACL is used to block or permit your network. So these are the interview questions, and in our next video, we will discuss about more interview questions. Thank you so much.